Nyakabande Refugee Transit Center, which is currently home to over 900 asylum seekers, continues to receive more people on a daily basis as fighting between the M23 rebels and the government soldiers continues in the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo. Since March 2022, the center has hosted over 80,000 refugees. While addressing the delegation, Matthew Crenshaw, the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees representative in Uganda, said that with the unpredictable refugee situation in the area and with the recent closure of the holding center, there is a need to expand it to avoid space challenges in future.
Some of the challenges were put to them, including expansion of the facilities there to be able to host more people. Like you rightly mentioned, if we have the tempo of the influx increasing, we may have to host more people at a time. So one of the requests that was made to the delegation was to help to improve on the facilities there and expand those facilities so that we'll be able to host more and more refugees if we have bigger influx coming in.
Crenshaw says the closure of the center in November 2022 helped them in reducing the burden they had with the asylum seekers in Chisoro district. However, in order to improve the transit center, it would be ideal since it is the only available point before heading to refugee camps.
Since it was not designed to be a camp, there were makeshift structures here and there, so sanitation was not that good. Health provision could have been improved, and so on and so forth.
About 146,000 refugees have been received in Uganda from the DRC and South Sudan since 2022. According to Pauline Abina, the refugee desk officer in the office of the Prime Minister in Barara, if the refugee numbers increase beyond what the holding center can accommodate, they will consider liaising with the Chisoro district authorities for a temporary space to meet the required needs.
We of course sometimes get the sudden increase of numbers due to the anticipated influxes, but I think in terms of space, like you have raised, we've been able to manage and we've been able to adjust. First of all, the current space that we have is adequate, but in the event that the numbers surpass the current space available, we always liaise with the district authorities to give an extension of where we can put more temporal structures to host people for a shorter time, and then we relocate them.
Abina says that financial challenges continue to affect Uganda's refugee response plan, and she called for more funding in this area.
So if we do not have, if it comes through the donors to the partners directly, so if partners do not have enough resources, of course it affects the capacity in terms of the manpower that is able to manage the people we serve here, and basically the funding is one of the biggest challenges.
Beruth Natmanya Bampa, the Deputy Director Program Operations at Save the Children International, noted that in most refugee settlement camps, children face challenges in accessing education, and therefore a more advanced strategy to solve this is required.
The ways we can improve this is trying to set up at least some educational facilities in the resettlement so that children can be able to access services. And also, one of the accelerated education program is kind of a bridging camp to make children catch up on the lost time.
In September, the United Nations High Commission for Refugees said it urgently required at least $68 million, about 250 billion Uganda shillings, for life-saving assistance and services amidst surging humanitarian needs for 96,000 refugees who fled to Uganda in 2022. Report by Job Namanya for the news.